lapin.
Oi, oi. Bit of respect. Can we have a bit of sorry, I did the wrong voice there. I forgot my voice. What is it again? That's a relief. I'm sorry, I forgot my voice because I was in the presence of Taylor.
Okay.
Say hello, Taylor.
Hello.
Taylor, tell the ladies and gentlemen your proper title because they're stupid.
I am Ms. Woman American Renaissance.
Miss Woman American Renaissance mean? What does it mean?
Well, American Renaissance is a national pageant system that highlights the average everyday woman.
All right. Mm-hmm. What's average and everyday about you? I mean, you got a crown on.
I don't wear it every day.
You don't?
Only when I come here.
You just wore it special for designing?
I did, just for you.
Oh, that's lovely. Oh, I feel such a fool. That's lovely, that. And that's a lovely sash.
Thank
that's
you.
Nice. Where is the pageant? Where is it held?
Last year was held in Orlando, and this year is in Las Vegas, actually on Saturday.
Oh, you went out on Saturday?
Yep.
Was there other normal American woman there as well? Was there a whole competition?
There is a whole competition of lots of
women. You have to walk up and down and tell people how normal you are.
Something like that.
Yeah. And the most normal person wins.
Sorry. Whoever fits in the crown, I suppose.
What are you laughing? I'm just trying to do the talk show and asking questions. Yeah, right, so you go a lot. Did you have to go through the semifinals?
I did. Oh. I came from Michigan and I went and represented Michigan at the national pageant.
Oh, that's
year.
Well, congratulations.
Thank
to you.
You
and the great state of Michigan. Do you get any money for winning?
I did.
How much did you get?
$1,000. Yes.
Is any competitions for rabbits?
Not that I'm aware of, but you could look.
I can look at what?
Google.
You're coming on to me.
Google.
You're coming on to me, aren't you?
Maybe. You're such a pretty rabbit.
You're right. Don't let my looks fool you. I might be pretty, but I'm a monster in the sack. I'm only kidding. Congratulations, Your Majesty. Well done.
Thank you.
Well, you see? Now, wasn't that lovely? Who needs anybody else? For example, some middle-aged Scottish puff. You could just have... I could do this. I was interviewing her, she was happy, I was happy, everyone was happy, it was all lovely. Now we'll go to a commercial break. I mean, it's not rocket science, is it?
Hey!
Ladies and gentlemen, Craig Ferguson.
Thanks very much. Please sit down. Relax, everybody. That's it. Don't worry. No, don't worry. The reign of terror that the warm-up comedian has you under is over. Your Prince Charming is here. I shall... Boy, knock it off. I shall kiss you and you will awake. You too, ladies. Ooh, what a summery looking audience. What a very summery. Whoa, who thought hobos would look so nice? And lovely hobos in floral print dresses.
We feel so pretty.
Lovely. Do you know what? What? It's a great day for America, everybody, yes, it is. It is a great day for America, but not such a great day for two Americans. Simon and Garfunkel have cancelled the rest of the summer tour.
I know.
I also went, oh, a little bit. It was going great, and then things got weird after the two of them hooked up in Albuquerque. Hello, darkness, my old friend. Do you know here in California, the state legislature, you know, the bastards that run the place are considering, they're considering a bill that would allow electronic advertisements around license plates. I'm like, what? That's dangerous. I, when I'm driving, I don't want anything to distract me from what I'm texting. There's too much to do already.
Look out.
Exactly, Jeff. Do you know that an heiress in Florida left $3 million to her dogs? And now the dog... I know. I also was kind of bored when I heard that. Oh. $3 million to her dogs, and the dogs are now technically the employers of the former staff members. And the dogs... smart, so they've picked it up. They know things have changed. They're like, oh, I'm just too tired to lick myself. I'm too tired. Jeeves? Jeeves, come on over, will you? Right away, sir. Which ball would you lick first? hey, it's a job. Don't knock it. You know that... It's summer solstice today. That's right. Today is the longest day of the year and also shortest night of the year. Coincidence? Even although this is the shortest night of the year, though, if you're watching this show, I'll, you know, lengthen it for you. It'll feel a little longer. I know it's short, but it'll feel longer once I get started. I've said that before. I love how at the peak of summer, though, right in the middle of summer, it's still kind of light outside, even though it's past midnight. Look at that there. Look, it's... So, boy, that's 20% more purple than it usually is. That happens whenever I get excited. It's 20% more purple. I'm getting heckled by that. Right, anyway, here in L.A., the summer solstice is, you know, we're celebrating with a huge parade for the world champion Los Angeles Lakers, who are now the world champions of basketballing. Well done, everybody. The Laker Parade has a lot in common with the traditional pagan ceremony for the solstice, so they'll be drinking and dancing and sacrificing the virgins by throwing them into the mouth of our pagan god. Do we have a picture of our pagan god here in LA? There he is. You know where at the summer solstice, you know what's always mobbed? Stonehenge. That's where everybody goes, Stonehenge. Experts think that Stonehenge may have been a huge prehistoric calendar, because today at the Healstone, the Healstone, the Stonehenge aligns with the ray of the suns, and the Druids carved sexy firemen into each of the 12 ringstones. Think that Stonehenge was built to attract UFOs, which, if it's true, that's possibly the reason why UFOs have never come back. Because if you're aliens and you travel over millions of miles of galaxy, you travel through space, you're not going to be that impressed by Stonehenge, are you? It's like, we have a spaceship powered by antimatter. What do you have? Well, we've got this lovely henge. Here. Look at that, a lovely circle of stones, all standing up. Ooh!
Let's get out of here, these people are morons.
Anyway, the summer solstice is a holiday when the Druids used to dance naked with huge bonfires. It's the only time of year I'm interested in Druids, you know, the naked. But the rest of the year, they just shuffled around in the mist dying of scurvy. Boring! Anyway, since the time of the Druids, the bonfires have been a big part of the summer solstice. The ancients believed that the bonfires scared off the dark spirits of the night. And I think, you know, even back then, there was nothing good on television. Your only option is dancing around the fire or watching this crap. Actually, we weren't on then. But Larry King was on then. The Druids used to hold a big summer solstice celebration at Stonehenge. Now, a Stonehenge, if you don't know, of course, is a group of old mossy stones that's been around for 2,000 years. Do we have a picture of old... There you are. The real Stonehenge. Let me see the real Stonehenge. There you are. Look at that. All stony and henge-y. You can't see it in the picture. Show me the picture again of Stonehenge. You can't see there. I've been there. It's also the site of ancient mounds. By the way, ancient mounds is the name I used to dance under. At a club called Bonehenge. Gentlemen, please welcome to Bonehenge for one night only. Ancient mounds. I know it looks smaller, but it'll feel longer once I get started. All right. We have to take a break, but when we come back, there's going to be naked people dancing around a fire. We won't be filming it. No, we will. I think the studio audience will remove their summer frocks, strip down to their one-piece underwear with the trap door at the back. That's what hobos wear. It is, isn't it? Gotta stay warm in those freight cars. Riding the rails to the Ferguson show. All right, we'll take a break. We'll be right back, everybody. We'll be right back. Peace out, Jimmy. All right. What time is it, Jeff?
Once again, it's tweets and email time.
Don't be all bitter, cause you ain't a quitter. I'm a baby sinner. Check damn Twitter. Yeah, complain. Also emails.
I look forward to your letters. All right, here's an email. This is from August in Lincoln, Nebraska. That's a good name, isn't it? For a novelist. I'd like to be called August and write novels. My name's August and I write novels. What, you mean you make up stories and you write it down? Yes. Is it allegorical? Yes. August says, hi, Craig. I have two goats named Lily and Becca, and every time I try to feed them, they attack and trample me. Do you have any suggestions on how to keep them back? Jeez.
That is so Craig.
That's right. They don't call me the goat shooter for nothing. I'm kidding. I would never shoot a goat. This is from Zane in Lebanon and Tennessee. Not the other Lebanon, which is further away. Hi, Craig. My family got cable last week and I think they ripped us off. What do you think I should do? No. You think you've been ripped off. That's actually just cable. You're like, how can it all be crap? I don't know, but it can. Like, when you sit down to watch TV, like you probably did tonight, and you've ended up here, I'm sorry, but I know. You're like, crap, 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 crap. Cussing rabbit? Crap, 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 crap. I think the cussing rabbit is awesome, huh? I tell you. If I don't get Emmy this year, it'll be a rip-off. What are you shaking your head at? Well, I didn't cuss, the rabbit cussed. We're out of time, so I can't read this, but I will. Roy from Long Mountain, Colorado. Is it Longmont? Oh, sorry, it's Longmont. Not as funny. Roy says, dear Craig, I have to do a comic strip for school. What do you think I should do? P.S. There are only four panels to draw in. Oh, I thought he meant a comedic strip. Off come the pants! I don't know. Draw a cartoon about a squiggly line that learns a lesson. Get your own series on PBS. We have to take a break now. I have a separation anxiety with the audience. I just have to go over it. We'll be right back. We'll be right back. Anyway, my first guest, I can't even go through this anymore. My first guest tonight is in the movie called Grown Ups, which is in theatres on Friday. Take a look at this.
Mommy, I want some milk.
Oh, sure, Angel. Come here. Give me a little something. Slow down, honey.
Your son is so cute.
Yeah.
How old is he?
Oh, he's 48 months. That's four. Yeah.
Please welcome the lovely Maria Bello, everybody. Maria Bello. Wow. Hey, Maria.
Hi, Craig. How are you?
I'm good. How are you doing?
Good.
That was some excellent breast work in the...
Thank you very much.
In the movie there, where you...
Well, it was the reason I was hired, actually. They needed someone with, like, double D boobs, and Adam Sandler thought of me. Seriously, that's the joke in the movie, that I breastfeed my son, and he's five.
Yeah.
I think.
That's kind of odd. Did you have to have special... Was that a real kid or a midget?
Midget.
Yeah, because you can't actually do that with a real kid you don't
know. It's true. They have all these rules. They have to be like 6 inches away. So,
yeah.
And half the time I was like, come on, kid, they're fake. But no.
They were fake?
I had to wear a contraption that was very heavy. It was
I've got one of those. 10 pounds
they made for me. You have a contraption too.
I have a contraption, but it's not breasts.
We can trade contraptions.
No, we can trade contraptions. You don't want to.
Yeah.
Maybe. You probably want to use some of this. How are sorry, Maria. What the hell has been going on with you?
Do you want some of this, by the way? I remember I have it, and then I just use it.
Do you know, I don't like it.
Oh, you don't?
No, it kind of grosses me out.
Really?
Yeah.
Are you kind of like the reverse Howie Mandel or something?
Yeah. I don't like it feeling sticky on my hand. It smells. I'd rather...
Look out.
Oh, you embarrassed me.
But I didn't embarrass you. I sat here rubbing my hands while you embarrassed yourself.
Myself.
Yes.
Right.
No, I said, what else have you been up to other than avoiding stuff that's sticky and smelly on your hands?
I've been in Haiti a lot.
The last
5 months.
How's it going over
the earthquake?
There?
Oh, fantastic.
No,
it's pretty horrendous.
I
mean, so many people have showed up from all over the world to help, but now it's hurricane season, and it's been really trying for the people. But you know, things are getting a little better, which is good.
Are you part of the, are you involved with the Red Cross or something over there?
No, not the Red Cross.
Oh, the Red Cross are bad?
No, I didn't say that.
Right,
No.
Take that, Red Cross.
Our organization, we've been working there for a few years, is Artists for Peace and Justice, which Paul Haggis started. I don't know if you know Paul.
I know Paul Haggis. I'm Scottish, and his name is Haggis. How do I not know? But also, I know Paul quite well, because when he was when he won the Oscars for Crash, he came directly on the show afterwards.
Oh, I didn't know that.
We had supported his movie a bit, and then, you know, then he won Oscars for it, and he didn't forget the little show that helped him out at the beginning, so he came back.
Isn't that nice? Yeah, he's a good one.
Yeah, he hasn't been back since, right enough. But but he did come on the show. He came on and he put the Oscars right there, and that's the closest I'll ever get to one.
I actually told him I was coming on your show, and he was like, who?
Yeah. That's it. That's so he remembers. No, he's very good. He's very philanthropic. Why do you get involved with all of that? Because Hollywood is such a selfish, kind of greedy, grasping society? Or are you just a good person?
Well, let me think.
Yeah.
No, the funny thing is people say that about Hollywood, and I have met the most generous people here, including you and your wife, by the way.
Yeah, my wife's not that generous.
And that's what she says about you.
I think that's true, actually. I think people here are quite generous. I just think sometimes they attach an agenda to it. Not that you do, but I do, you know.
Yeah, I get that. But now instead of going back to Haiti, I'm going to Paris this week.
You're going to Paris?
I am.
No way.
Yeah, I'm finally taking myself on sort of an alone vacation.
Are you going to, on your own?
Yes.
Oh, you are so going to get busy. Are you going to sit around cafes like...
Yes.
Get a hat that goes like that over one eye.
I'm bringing one.
Yeah, you need one.
I'm bringing a hat like that.
And then do that. Don't smoke. Just do that with your fingers.
I started smoking a little bit again.
Oh, you did?
I did. I quit. We talked about this. And then started,
you started smoking a little bit again?
But just like 4 or 5 a day.
Oh, fine. Yeah, that's fine. So you only get a little bit of cancer.
And I owe Jack money for that. Every time he...
Jack, your kid. Yeah,
Jack,
your boy,
my kid.
Yeah.
Every, 9.
Yeah,
same
wow.
Years,
yeah,
and he finds out I have a cigarette, and every time I curse, like Sid, I owe him $5. I owe him like $300.
Oh, quiet, Sid.
Sid would owe him a lot of money.
Yeah, no, Sid's a very cussy rabbit. But that's quite a lot of money putting out, because you're a very potty mouthed person. I know this. And
it's true.
And then $20 a day for your smoke.
I know. I'm really.
That's
I'm
a lot.
Losing.
You know,
a lot of money.
I think you should go. Mind you, you are going to Paris. You probably want to stop smoking after you've been there.
Well, that's what I think. Because everyone smokes in
no,
Paris.
They actually banned it in cafes there now.
That's what I heard, but not outside in cafes, and it is summer.
No, they've banned
it. I'm not trying to promote smoking here.
Maria Bello is promoting smoking and hates the Red Cross. I'm kidding. It's a joke. It's a joke. Everybody knows you love the Red Cross, you love America, you hate Al Qaeda,
and you
love smoking, but you're trying to quit, and you know you're using money to help you.
Thank you for making me seem like the saint that I am. I really appreciate that.
Why are you going to Paris? Just for a holiday?
Just for fun, because I have friends that live there in Paris, and I want to
so
go.
Awesome. It's a great city, Paris.
It is. I know.
I haven't been there in a while.
But you probably were able to take the Channel and do all that when you lived in Scotland. No? Oh, no, you were too. You didn't spend a lot of time in Paris.
I spent plenty of time in Paris. Yeah, being... It's okay. You're actually allowed to be
in Paris.
Yeah, but there you go. Well, we're done here.
Oh, we are?
Yeah.
Already?
Apparently, yeah.
Well, okay.
I know, that's fast,
that
isn't it?
That was so fast.
I know.
I always love seeing you.
What the hell? Is the movie good?
Pretty funny.
Yeah, yeah.
Well, think about those guys, Adam.
No, they're pretty funny.
Kevin James, Chris Rock, they're hilarious.
They're pretty funny. And then you with the big boob contraption on. It sounds like
exactly.
A
woman.
Big summer favorite.
Yeah, and it's a family film. You can bring your kids and everyone.
Really?
So, yeah.
You can bring everyone?
Yeah.
Come on, everyone. Let's go see this movie. But we don't have any money. Don't worry, I'll pay. That's good.
Definitely bring everyone.
All right. Everyone, go and see, what is it, How to Train Your Dragon?
How could you forget?
I didn't forget. How to Train Your Dragon is my movie. It's still in one theater. All right, the lovely Maria Bello, everybody. We'll be right back. Show. Hey, you know, during the commercial break, I had a bit of a quandary. I had a quandary because I was thinking, I started feeling my voice was going a little funny. You know? Like this, and I thought, well, I'm turning into Roger Moore. And then Sandy, who's on camera, what number is your camera? Two. Sandy said, no, it's more like Pierce Brosnan. And I'm like, Roger Moore, Pierce Brosnan? Who can it be? Why don't you send us an email or a Twitter? And tell us how we can be better. All right, my next guest tonight is a wonderful actor. He's in a new television show called Memphis Beat. Which is a bit of an obscure way of masturbating. It's, people who enjoy pleasuring themselves to the music of Elvis Presley. It premieres. Whole lot of shaking going on. It premieres. We should write some of this down, really. It premieres on June the 22nd, which is tomorrow, on the TNTs. Take a look at this.
That window up there was wide open, and there's these footprints. So I figure that's how we fled. I got patrol cameras in a 10-block radius as we speak.
Big feet, tiny window. Would have been a tight squeeze. These are yours, Sutton.
What?
Yep, you tracked him through the scene, damn it.
No.
Lock this place down.
Please welcome DJ Qualls, everybody. DJ Qualls. Hey, DJ.
How are you, brother?
I'm good, my friend. How are you doing?
Thank you for having me back.
It's always nice to see you. I'm always very happy to see you. That's a very swanky looking leather jacket you're wearing.
I get to keep it if I wore it on the air.
You're kidding me.
No, so that's why I wore it.
Really? Oh, it's awesome. Is it from a swanky designer?
No, it's from, you know what? I don't know who made it, but I get to keep it if I wear it on TV.
It looks very nice. You look very trendy. Did you get that down? Are you making the show in Memphis?
No, we're shooting in Louisiana, in New Orleans.
Oh, all right.
It's cheaper. But we do go to Memphis a couple times a month to shoot.
I like
series.
Memphis. You like Memphis,
I
right?
love Memphis,
Yeah,
man.
Memphis is great.
It's great.
Yeah, because you're an Elvis fan, aren't you?
Oh, yeah, absolutely. And I beat it in Memphis.
Do you enjoy pleasuring yourself?
Yeah, exactly. I was just going to say that.
Really?
That's the only time I do it, so I got to get back there.
Yeah, yeah. Now, for example, does it turn you on, if I was just to go, you ain't no mother hound dog, is that, do you feel stirrings just when I say that?
I got a semi right now.
Can you say that? A semi? A semi is a truck, young fella.
No, so New Orleans, eh? That's that's quite the place. So you're going nuts and drinking and getting beads and showing your boobies to everybody?
I've shown my boobies to anybody who wants to see them. Not very many people want to see them, surprisingly enough.
Well, the competition's fierce down there.
It
I don't
really
want to, you know, I'm not wanting in any way to talk down your boobies, but there's some very attractive boobies available to view.
Pretty boobies in New Orleans. It's on the license plate of Louisiana.
Really?
Yeah.
I know.
No, but there's a lot of drinking.
Yeah,
it takes you about a month to get acclimated. At this point, I'm about 100 pounds of body weight, 50 pounds of liver.
Really?
Yeah, but I'm good. I'm good. I've calmed down recently. It was my birthday a couple weeks ago.
Happy birthday.
Thank you. Thank you. Whoa, whoa, whoa. I didn't say that for a part.
It was a couple of weeks ago.
Yeah,
never
overdo
it. But it's past. The moment's gone.
Right, but birthdays in New Orleans are to be dreaded because they keep going and they keep going and the shots. And, like, I remember about, like, 3 days of those 10-day period, and the other day my buddy was like, remember the other night we were in the back of this guy's van headed uptown? And I'm like, I do not remember that, and that's a warning sign.
No, a blackout is a little bit further on than a warning sign, DJ. A warning sign is, I'll just have another one before I go to work. A blackout is a sign of brain damage occurring during alcoholism. That's what that is.
But listen, what I've started doing, every 2 weeks I'll stop drinking for a week, and if I start shaking, I'm not going to drink again.
Hey, you got it correct.
That's right.
Yeah.
I've got
absolutely nothing to worry about from now on.
But I think they should, like, so much production is happening in Louisiana. I think there's like 11 movies shooting there right now.
Really?
Yeah. And you always notice, like, you'll see a really famous actor, like, staggering down the street, and we're all like...
Who?
We're all like, I'll tell you off the air. No. And we're all like, oh, he just got here. Because people come there, and they want to do everything in one night. Like, everything you possibly could think of doing in Vegas, people want to do in one night in New Orleans.
Really?
Yeah, I mean, I did it that one night, and it's not worth it.
I'm worried about you, man.
You shouldn't.
Yeah, you're all right? You're good with it?
Yeah,
all right.
I'm doing well.
Yeah, okay.
I got your book.
Oh,
I'm going to read it, yeah.
Yeah, you want to read that,
because
there's a story of what can happen if you don't, you know.
I'm using you as my role model.
Oh, no. No, that's not good at all. Go over to Memphis. Have you been to Graceland in Memphis?
I just went back. We had a press thing in Memphis, and we got to see one of Elvis's best friends from childhood took us through the mansion, and we got to see it from his perspective. Like, he was like, this is what happened here, and these are the girls that we did.
Hey, no.
Like, no. He did.
We don't talk
he
like that anymore.
You just said, ooh, la, la. Like, 15 times.
I don't think. No. That's, you're thinking of Fallon. You don't get any of that stuff right here. All right, it may have slipped out occasionally. Yeah, all right.
But it was neat, and it reminded me of when, I mean, to a lot lesser scale, when I first made a little money acting. Like, you really, it's called Redneck Rich. You anything that you can think of that, like, to put on your body to make yourself look rich or to put in your house, it was all mirrors. Like, you had a room that was completely pleated with this peacock fabric. The jungle room is...
I've seen it. I've been there.
Yeah, but it's not...
It's not really a room.
He never called it the jungle room. It's an outdoor porch.
Yeah.
It was kind of disappointing, Elvis, I gotta say.
Yeah. Did you go to the cars, though? The cars are awesome.
They didn't show us the cars.
Well, that's the best part. The cars and the planes.
We didn't see them.
He had three planes.
I didn't see them. I got
jerked.
I'm not sure I went to Graceland.
You sure you went to Graceland?
No.
Did some guy just take you in his trailer?
He totally did. And over here.
Yeah, DJ, this is Graceland. Now lie down there. Man, want a little Rohypnol in here? Is that what they call it, Rohypnol?
You know.
Yeah,
come on.
I've got a big bottle of it right here, yeah. Well, that sounds like you're having fun then. You good?
Yeah, this is the best job I've ever had. Playing a cop? Whoever would have thought I was going to play a cop?
You look a bit like a cop.
Oh, thanks. But, like, I was telling people when I first got the show that I was playing a cop, and I got this, like, a real cop? And I'm like, yeah. But it's great because I'm tasing people and shooting people and jumping off roofs.
It's all
really,
the cop
really fun
right there.
Exactly. Isn't that what cops do?
Yeah! Yes, that's all. What about the donuts? You haven't got to them then yet.
Donuts.
Really?
No.
Yeah. Did you do any of the ride-alongs with the real cops?
No, but they told us we got to go to the police station.
Oh, well, there you go. That's
That was all the research we needed.
Yeah, I've got to go to a police station or two before as well.
That's what I was going to say. I'm relying on my past experience with law enforcement.
Yeah, yeah. It's different from their point of view, though, the cops. So, like, after, you know, I sobered up and stopped getting into trouble, I actually, you know, got to meet and got friendly with cops.
They're really, really nice people.
They're nice.
And you know that cocky walk that cops have, like that sort of, like, swagger?
Yeah.
I realized after I put on the gun belt, it weighs like 15 pounds. Mm-hmm. It changes. You have to walk like that.
Yeah.
Like you, just to keep your pants up.
Yeah.
And it pulls down your underwear. So I'm going to invent something that keeps up your underwear and make $1 million. So I don't have to keep coming back on this show.
You know, how do I get me some of that sweet underwear action? I'd like to be part of that.
I want this job. When you fire him, I want this job.
I love this job.
you can't, man.
I can fit that outfit. You know.
All right. Well, you know he's got beads there. You see he's got beads. You know how he got them.
He showed his
tutti frutti. Yeah, that's right. Yeah.
That Craig.
This show got weird.
Yeah, I know. It's because I stopped giving. I can have a. Yeah. It's the weirdest thing. I know. Yeah. Well, we're out of time. So,
so
knock it off, you.
Okay.
So, anything you want to wrap it up with? Any kind of like moments of wisdom? Stuff you want to say?
No, this is my favorite show to come on, though.
Ooh la la!
This is my favorite show to appear on. God damn it.
We'd prefer if you did that in your dressing room.
We were doing so, I do it in Memphis. We were doing so well. You can't open it to me. You have to be the funny one. I can't,
hey, if I've got to be the funny one on this show, we're both up.
What's a coming creek?
Sorry, we're both up. What's a coming ago creek? all right, so we're done. Anyway, that's it. So stop interrupting me.
Okay.
All right. So let me wrap it up like a professional.
Okay, do it.
All right.
What did we learn on the show tonight, Greg?
It doesn't make any sense. The cat's got a human skull. So if the cat has a human skull, then there's a human body inside the cat, which means the cat is, what, a human in drag? Do you know there is that thing, these people that like to get together dressed as animals and have sex? Like, every time I hear about something like that, I think, I am so vanilla. Like, I think I'm freaky and stuff, but I'm not. People get, like, dress up as bears and cats and stuff and, like, get it on. All I need is a couple of hookers, some blow and a midget. I'm good. I don't need anything fancy. I'm an old-fashioned romantic. Now, listen, I said tonight something rather disrespectful. I said that the show Memphis Beat was about people that like to pleasure themselves while listening to the music of Elvis Presley. I'd like to apologize for that. But unfortunately, I can't. And I'll tell you why. Because I have a trouble with intimacy. And if I apologize, then you'll get to know the real me and you'll see inside I'm just frightened. I'm not who you think I am. I'm frightened, caring, good person. Inside, I'm like a tiny little pig. A tiny pig made of cream cheese. Tiny pigs made of cream cheese? Doesn't that sound delicious? Onto my bagel, Porky. Well, that was the show then. That was the big Monday night show. And I tell you one thing, I think we're back on form. And I think we really sorted ourselves out over the weekend. Right, well, look, we better get going, but here's the good news. We'll be back tomorrow. Yeah, all right, there you go.